I stand before you, a Unison activist. I stand before you, the daughter of an ordinary working man. My father worked in a factory his whole life, a job he hated. My mum was a teacher. They worked their whole lives, as we do, to better the lives of their children. Today, I watch them as pensioners, struggling and scraping by with so very, very little. I stand before you, a sister. My younger brother, seriously disabled as a result of an injury at work. I watch him struggle every day, not only with his physical disability, but with money worries as he negotiates his way around welfare reforms, cuts to benefits and to the services he so depends on. I watch a young man at the age of 30 resigned to a life of struggle, compromise and nothingness. I watch his spirit take blow after blow after blow. I stand before you, a working mother. I stand before you, a health worker. I stand before you, someone working over 40 hours a week. I stand before you, an example of the working poor. I stand before you, demanding a decent wage for us all. We are all aware since the 70s wages have not kept pace with the cost of living. But on top of that, wages have been frozen, jobs have been cut or outsourced, pensions diminished, and morale has been ripped to shreds. I have never seen a time like this before. Many of us using loans or credit cards to pay for everyday essentials. Many of us forced to turn to charities and food banks. We juggle with heating, oil and costs, robbing Peter to pay Paul. Soon welfare reforms will bring more hardship for the unemployed, the vulnerable, the disabled. Water charges will soon be on the table, as will patient and staff car parking charges, the privilege of paying to park at work or when you're in need of help and treatment. This is not living. This is merely surviving. We want a decent future so we can start to strive for a better future, to once again have aspirations and a little joy in our lives for us and our families. Surviving is not good enough anymore. We have had enough. Are we all in this together? Is it tough for everyone? I'll answer that for you. No. Not if you're Mr. Millionaire, Mr. Cameron, son of millionaire, nor one of his millionaire cabinet ministers making decisions about our futures. Not if you're one of the top chief executives earning 185 times more than the average wage. That's the equivalent of what the average man earns in 12 months in a day and a half. Not if you're one of our MLAs earning on average between 43 and 48,000 a year. Add 11,000 on if you're a committee chair, sprinkle on some expenses, struggling, I think not. Perhaps our MLAs are at best a little compliant, or at worst, very, very arrogant. We vote on our issues that divide us, not on the issues that should unite us. Let us give them a wake-up call. The government has set up a review body, the same independent review body that deemed a 1% pay rise satisfactory for us, has recommended that MPs get 10%. On top of that, there are cries that this insulting 1% cannot be afforded. We haven't even been afforded a decision here yet. Let's look at some of the other filth churned out by the Tory propaganda machine in our government. Let's take a look about what's happening in the silence. Myth one, there are generations of workers that have not worked. Untrue. Myth two, benefits are too generous. Simply untrue. I could go on and on, but the Tory filth machine has done that for me on a daily basis as it tries to turn working class people against working class people. I'd rather focus on what's happening in the silence. Let's look at a novel new approach, Mr. Cameron. Let's tax the rich. Since 2007, the British government has handed Disney almost 170 million to make films here. Last year alone, the California giant took 50 million in tax credits. By way of comparison, next April, the government will scrap a 347 million crisis fund for families on the verge of homelessness and starvation. Benefits are what we grudgingly hand to the poor. The rich are awarded tax breaks. Tories believe that hundreds given to people living on the streets are unaffordable, but as the journalist said last week, those millions given to Disney are apparently money well spent. Whoever coined the phrase taking the mickey must have worked for Her Majesty's revenue. Politicians talk about welfare as if it is solely cash given to the poor. Never mentioned is the corporate welfare, the grants, the contracts and the cut price loans that governments give to our biggest companies. Look at Amazon last year paying less in corporation tax to the UK than it received in government grants. People, it's time for change. Let's take this fight on. Let's be a country united against inequality, deprivation and poverty. We have little defence individually, but please take away from today the power of the collective. Go home and talk within your homes. Dispel the myths and join a union. I commend my Unison brothers and sisters in England who took decisive and powerful industrial action this week. Know that together a collective strength is needed to fight for our future. Mr. Cameron and our government, you may try to dilute employment rights, you may try to deplete union rights, but you will not divide us. You are in fact building our resolve. Your propaganda machine is failing. People are now seeing what your benefit bashing really is. We have so very, very little to fight for. We have so very little to lose and so much to fight for. Mr. Cameron, you have underestimated the collective, the anger, the frustration and the fear of the working man. Greed is the religion of the billionaire class. A nation based on greed will not survive morally, economically or politically. So as you continue to protect your big business and the rich that bankroll your party, just think a little way down the road, what party? As working class people stand up and demand a future, we say, Mr. Cameron, get down on your knees and apologise for the hardship you have caused. Mr. Cameron, enemy of all decent, hard-working people, I stand before you defiant. I call for a properly enforced minimum wage. I call for a crackdown on excessive executive pay and unadulterated greed. I call for a crackdown on tax evasion and tax avoidance. I call for more social housing. I call for our MLAs to stand up, be accountable, and remember who they represent. I ask that we all stand together as a collective, shoulder to shoulder, united against greed and Mr. Cameron's dirty little class war. I call for a higher wage for us all. If we all stick together like never before, we can all stand together